Hi. All right, a little background before I share this empty apartment tour. It's obviously not empty right now, but you're gonna be seeing an empty version of this. Back in June of 2019, I ended up moving to Southern California for a job. I worked there for about 8 months, and then I decided it was time to move back to Chicago, which was in February of 2020. And then a month later, I had kind of impeccable timing to move back home, but then COVID happened. Coronavirus, pandemic, crazy shit. So when I moved back in February, I had moved back with my mom trying to figure out what my next steps were. And when the pandemic hit, I just kept doing my thing, but I was stuck there for 6 months. And I was actually just planning to ride it out until all of this just kind of ended, but really with no particular end in sight, I figured it was time to get my own place again. I was working out of a bedroom. I was sleeping in there too, and it was just, you know, I'm very thankful that my mom gave me a place to stay, but it was too much. All right, so as we walk into the apartment here, you will get a glimpse of the living room area and the bedroom area. Yes, it is a very small apartment. I'm putting my sofa or couch, TV, and bed in this area here. What I do like is the big bright windows, the big windows that offer a lot of bright light. I'm steps away from the bus and I'm 2 blocks away from the train. So to the left here is the kitchen. And you have this like bar area here. Get a couple bar stools and it'll be a good place to eat or, I don't know, prep food. And then, you know, you have your basics, a stove, a sink, and a fridge. And even though it looks like there's not a ton of storage, if you actually walk around here to the left, you'll notice that they put these cabinet doors that offer more shelving or more storage. And trust me, when you live in a very small apartment, you want to have as much storage like options as possible. And you can tell, like, the countertops aren't, they're not high-end or anything, but it still has a good look to it. I really do like the subway tile, or the bigger subway tile. Now, the grout or the caulk or whatever it's called is beige. I really would have preferred white, but I'll take it. I should also mention that the walls in this apartment are gray. For a hot second, I was planning on painting this place just like white on white, but it's so time consuming. And if I even wanted to like hire someone to do it, it's money I don't have. And then you can see out the windows here, you have just a great view of my little piece of Chicago. You know, you have the green in the trees, and in the winter, it's gonna look beautiful too with the snow. Well, it'll look beautiful at first, and then I'll get tired of the snow sooner or later. But it's a great view regardless. If we go down the street here, you'll see that, you know, it's city life, but there's so much greenery around. I think a lot of people have this misconception about city living, or at least here in Chicago. Like, if you've never lived in Chicago, or if you've never really been in Chicago other than like visiting the Bean or going downtown, you really don't know what it's like in these like residential neighborhood areas. Cause yeah, you're close to everything, shops and restaurants and, you know, just parks or whatever. There's just a very like neighborhood feel that is hard to explain until you're like kind of in it. I know that might not make sense, but it's one of the things that I love about Chicago that you really can't find in other places, because you have everything kind of just next to you. And then you have public transit to just get around easily, so you don't need a car. I had bought a car in Southern California because you need a car to get around, but here in Chicago, you don't need one. You're pretty much steps away from everything. Okay, so back to the apartment. So to the left of the kitchen, you'll see the entrance to the apartment here, but then you'll see this little area. Sorry, the focus kind of got messed up here, but you'll see this little area, and this is where I plan on putting my office. I want to put my desk here and, you know, set up my PC and my monitors. So let's move on. To the left of this is the closet. This is actually a walk-in closet. I should have just walked in there to give you proof that it is a walk-in, but it is. It's a good amount of space. It is the only closet though in this apartment. So I'm gonna make the best of it and, you know, hopefully I can put everything in here. What I like though about this closet too are the doors are mirrored. So that is a good way to utilize the space. All right, so opposite of the walk-in closet is the bathroom. Now, the bathroom I think is pretty nice too. It's not huge, but the one thing I love about this bathroom is this glass block window. It's a good way to bring in light, but also give you privacy, and then the basics. So, you know, your tub, shower tub, whatever, sink. And then the only thing that I notice is that there is no medicine cabinet where the mirror is here. So when it comes to storage, it's only under the sink. Oh, one more thing. This is a window AC unit. This thing weighed, I think, 59 pounds. That's what the box said. I have to double check. But somewhere around 60 pounds. I drag this thing for half a block down. I look like an idiot trying to... I thought I could have carried it half a block. And then I had to drag this thing up 3 flights of stairs. So the one thing I didn't point out is that I live on a 3-story walk-up. I counted the steps. There are 48 steps and I had to carry this thing up 3 flights of stairs. I remember the next day I could not feel my arms. I was so sore from it, but it was a good workout. So yes, no elevators, no none of that. It's good exercise. Anyway, that's pretty much it for my apartment. That's my apartment in a nutshell. 375-ish square feet. Has everything that I need, and hopefully I can make all of this work and show you what it looks like after I get everything, you know, decorated and, well, or at least most of it. I do plan on making another video showing everything that's in here, the things I've moved in, but I don't want to do that just yet because I still have bookcases coming in. I want to hang up the bike behind me. I want to hang up the TV that's over there. And then just kind of get the final like touches in. Oh, curtains and everything as well. There's a lot of stuff I want to do. I kind of nerd out when it comes to interior decorating. I'm not the best at it, but you know, I kind of have an eye for a couple things and I just want to share that. So I don't know when I'll have that video up. Maybe a month from now. It just depends when I can get like the rest of the things in here. I don't make a ton of money, so I still need to save up for a couple other things. But when I do, I'll put a video out and I'll share it with you guys then. So I'm really awful at like closing these things out. So I'm just gonna wave by like I normally do as I fade this out or put some kind of transition slot, or I don't know. Bye guys. I'll see you in the next one. Later.